Good afternoon, Cornerstone, man. Look at this glorious, beautiful day out here. The sun is shining. It feels good. It feels good to get that sun on my skin. It feels nice. Speaking of that, Psalms 90, verse 12, the psalmist here is telling us to teach us to number our days that we might gain a heart of wisdom. You know, sometimes our days get so full and so busy that we forget how precious and how fragile our time on this earth really can be. And so it's easy to allow these little things to creep in, to steal our joy, to steal our peace, to steal our thought life even. Maybe sometimes things don't go our way. Maybe somebody did say something to you that didn't quite settle just right. It was a little upsetting. Sometimes I found, you know, even traffic can cause us to lose our focus from time to time. If you've ever rode in the car with me. Listen, if we let it, I'm telling you, we got to remember each day is a gift. And if we choose to focus on everything that is wrong in life, it's going to be very overwhelming. But if we do that, we're going to miss out on the beauty each day has to offer. We need to get up every day with an expectation that this is the day the Lord has made. I'm going to rejoice. And so I encourage you today, like this verse says, number your days. Don't let these precious moments of life pass you by. Don't wait for holidays and birthdays to tell the ones that you love how much they mean to you, how much you care about them. Listen, remember, each day is unique. Each day is irreplaceable. Once time is gone, you can't get it back. It's a gift from heaven that we need to cherish. And so the time that we've been given, it can either be invested or it can be wasted. Hours can be used or they can be misused. And so I believe that's why this verse is teaching us, Father, teach us to number our days. That's what he's saying here. Teach us to value every moment that we've been given. Teach us, Father, to place value in the time that we have with our loved ones. Teach us, Father, to live a life that's pleasing to you. I'm telling you, this is the way that God wants to live our lives. Do you receive it? Let me pray for you. Heavenly Father, I thank you for the gift of this day. I thank you, Father, that as we go through life, that we choose to focus on the blessings of the moment and not the circumstances around us. Thank you, Father, that we don't allow little things to steal our joy, to consume our thought life. Father, we ask you that you would keep us close as we submit every area of our hearts and minds to you. In the name of Jesus, we ask. Listen, I encourage you today. Carpe diem. Seize the day. It's a good day. It's the day the Lord has made. And so listen, I call you blessed. And as always, remember, we are stronger together. Amen.